You work at your job. You know, John, one of the things that impressed me, or first impressed me about you, was at an interview. I interviewed you for the first time, I remember. And shortly after that, there was to be a party at which you were the hostess. And you made a point of remembering my husband's name. You had never met him, but as we entered, you greeted us by my married name, which was terribly impressive to me, and it was one indication that you work at it. And I just have the feeling that today, stars aren't willing to work that much outside of the immediate profession, and let's say, acting itself.
Well, I'm sorry, there is a social life outside of the motion picture industry and TV, which we all do part-time on now, as you know, guest appearances. But the social amenities, I think, are terribly, terribly important. And if you can remember lines, you can remember names and faces. Once in a while, I have a block on a name, but I take great pride in remembering names and where I met the people and what countries, what areas. And in traveling all over the world as I do, it's I have to be briefed every now and then before I go into a new area.
You travel all over the world on Pepsi-Cola business.
Yes, we're in 97 countries, and I think I've been in about 35 of them. Can't wait to get to the rest of them.
And you fly, too, which you didn't used to do one time.
Oh, I used to think traveling from Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer to 426 North Bristol was the greatest thing in the world, but now I take a plane like a, you know, I'd call a taxi and head out.
You first learned to fly, as I remember, through your husband, Al Steele.
Yes, I did. We flew to get married, and I've been flying ever since.
You didn't make any pictures during your marriage, did you?
No, I traveled with him.
I'm sure there are times that you think of Al. Joan, do you feel especially lonely when you do think of him?
It's a very lonely life, actually, when you close that door at night and you've been busy all day. It's extremely lonely. But you just keep going and be grateful for the loveliness you've had in life and take it from there and try and create more loveliness for other people the next day.
I should imagine that you're in your position, Joan, that you probably have many, many acquaintances and actually very few friends.
Well, I have many, many friends. I'm very grateful for that, but I take the time to make them. And I take the time to also keep them as friends. Lots of times you meet wonderful people along the way, but you don't bother to write to them or contact them when you're in town or when you're away or when you think of something, when you look at something in a store window, you say, that belongs to so-and-so. And just, it takes a minute to go home and write a note.
I know, and you're a prolific writer because I've received your letters, for which I've been most grateful. Joan, how long a gap was there between the caretakers and the previous motion picture?
1 week.
Oh, no, that was one before the caretakers.
The best of everything.
Three years.
3 years.
Mm-hmm. What was it like going back?
Well, I was delighted to do the caretakers first. We did 3 weeks filming in 1 week. They started the film before I got there. I was doing a tour for Pepsi-Cola in seven cities in Italy and two in Spain. And so they shot, I think, 10 days to 2 weeks before I arrived, and they condensed all of mine and saved all of it till I got there. And then I finished that one, and that kind of prepared me for my 2 weeks rehearsals and 31 shooting days with Betty Davis.
Speaking of Betty Davis, many reporters tried to create some rivalry between the two of you, didn't they? At least they alluded to that in their newspaper stories. Was there anything to that?
Not at all, Marie. My goodness, we're too professional. We had too much work to do, and it was just wonderful. In the first time in my whole career did we ever have 2 complete weeks of rehearsal. I've been promised it before, but it was very exciting. When we did start filming, we knew exactly what we were going to do. The chemistry between us was so perfect and so amenable, and we excited each other and stimulated each other. It was very, very great.
Tell me this, when you're alone at night and think about the coming bout, which is this Thursday, isn't it?
Yes, that's right.
Don't you just a little bit nervous, perhaps not as sure of yourself as you might sound in public?
Well, there are possibilities that my prediction may not work out, but just in case of that, I have told the public and the world that if you don't fall in the round I call, I'm catching the next jet out of the country.
How long have you been fighting, Cassius?
I've been fighting 11 years. 180 amateur fights.
You mean when you were 10 years old?
Yes.
Where do you fight at 10 years old?
We have a local television program in Louisville, Kentucky called Tomorrow's Champions.
Uh-huh.
And they gave it the right name.
And what about the future? You know, boxers don't last too long, really, or don't have too long.
Well, no, fighters such as Sugar Ray Robinson and Archie Moore, great fighters last long. Ordinary fighters don't last too long. But I plan to be here 10 years, and then after I hold the championship for 10 years, I'm going to give it to my brother Rudolph, like the Kennedy boys do in Washington.
Well, good luck to you. I hope you have that kind of luck.
Thank you.
Mrs. Salinger, you've managed so well to remain in the background that I'm sure there are people who don't know that there is a Mrs. Salinger. Is that on purpose?
I think so, primarily.
Are you like Mrs. Kennedy? You value your privacy?
Very much so.
Tell me about being Mrs. Salinger. Does it mean that you must entertain a great deal?
Well, we entertain some. Not terribly much.
I mean, on any official capacity?
Well, we've entertained Khrushchev's son-in-law a couple of times. We entertained him very informally.
How do you entertain him? What do you do?
Well, on this occasion, my husband cooked chicken over the barbecue outside.
He did himself?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
That must have been interesting to him. I'm sure this is something you wouldn't find in Russia.
No, I don't think so.
Well, what about your children? Is it difficult because they are children of Pierre Salinger?
Well, we've had some problems, but by and large, it hasn't been too much of a problem.
What kind of problem would there be?
Well, I sometimes think, you know, that other kids sort of take advantage of them and are envious of them, and it makes them feel awkward.
Mm-hmm. How about you? Are you often asked about the Kennedys because you are Mrs. Salinger?
Occasionally. But most of what I know about the Kennedys is what you know, too.
tell me about some of your husband's hours. Do you find that when you entertain, for instance, they may have to answer phones or have to go out?
Well, he does have to answer the phone, yes, all the time, it mm-hmm. seems like.
Well, in the middle of dinner?
Always, yes.
Mm-hmm.
It's ever present.
Mm-hmm. How about, does he have any idiosyncrasies in the house?
Well, I don't know about that. He doesn't clean off his desk. That's the only thing he can stand.
I wonder if he does that at the White House.
Yes, he does. One of his secretaries once asked me if I could do something about it, and I said, well, no, that there wasn't a great deal I could do. I'd tried.
How much do you see of him, though?
Well, I think, actually, I see more of him than people think I do, and more of him than a lot of... Why, more of him than some wives see of their husband, because, you know, he only travels when the president travels, and it's not a great deal. And he is home every night at 8, contrary to the rumor that he's, you know, stays at the office until late, because he doesn't.
Well, some of us have the idea that he probably has to sleep over at the White House some nights.
Well, this did happen recently, but it's, I guess that was the only time.
Was that something involving...
During the Cuban crisis.
The Cuban crisis.
Yeah.
Someone told me that he plays the piano, too.
Yes, he does.
Does he do that for relaxation around the house?
No, not so much around the house. We have a very poor piano. I think that's the reason.
Well, let's hope that at some future time, maybe Christmas time, you might get a new
well,
one.
Well, we are getting a new piano.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Mrs. Salinger. Like my attire? This is nothing designed by Dior or Igor Cassini. It is called a gi, and it is used in the art of judo. I am at the judo school of Pittsburgh, and I'd like to show you what goes on here. One of the principal members of the judo school of Pittsburgh is Bob Bowes. Here he is.